Next speaker, Natalia Miakova from Moscow. She presents our good results in treatment of the B-cell lymphomas.
Good afternoon. Thanks for the opportunity to share our data here today. To begin with, the situation with B-cell malignancies in children 15 years ago was very poor. Only 5% of children could survive after treating with CHOP-like protocols. Moreover, even introduction of intensive BFM protocols didn't improve the situation dramatically. Due to different difficulties, as in previous talk, low capacities of the hospitals, low level of knowledge between physicians, low level of supportive care, and that point that the majority of children came to the hospitals in very poor condition due to advanced stages. All of these things resulted only in 45% of three-year event-free survival. There were some ways to solve these problems, to develop high technologies, to try and train personnel, and also we thought about something which could be effective but not so toxic as intensive chemotherapy. We put our attention to rituximab because it showed promising results in adults. And our first small study was done in order to assess feasibility and toxicity of rituximab in children. They were 14 patients with residual tumors or with relapsed B-cell lymphoma. And you can see that the level of complete response was quite satisfactory. 12 of 14 responded well. We didn't see any severe allergic reactions or late neutropenias, and we concluded that rituximab could be safely and effectively used in childhood. Our first trial was called BNHL-2004M, where we included children with advanced stages of B-cell lymphomas, those who belong to risk group 3, because it was the most difficult population with poor condition at admission, with ascites, pleuritis, and so on. And we proposed for such patients to decrease dose of methotrexate in the first and second blocks from 5 to 1 gram per square meter, and to introduce rituximab in fixed intervals in standard dose 4 times. There were 8 centers, pediatric hospitals, who participated in this study, and the results, results were quite good. You can see that event-free survival is still about 80, and the level of complete response was about 90. One more thing which we noticed from this study was that those children who had isolated bone marrow disease without any extramedullary lesions responded very fast. They got remission after first or second block with rituximab. So our next study is protocol BNHL-2010M. And in this protocol, we decided to introduce rituximab to all risk groups and to assess the response with modern techniques as PET-CT also, in order to understand which kind of children requires correction of therapy or intensive therapy with bone marrow transplant. Here is the design of this protocol. You can see that the last group, risk group 4, we separated it especially for children with isolated mature B-cell leukemia, and then they have a little bit reduced course if they are in remission from the first blocks. Here are our results. About 200 patients were registered in the study. 180 were analyzed. You see that the majority of them had Burkitt lymphoma or Burkitt leukemia, then diffuse large B-cell lymphoma, primary mediastinal lymphoma, and unclassifiable between Burkitt and diffuse large B-cell. Most of patients belonged to third risk group, so they had still advanced stages of disease. And among them, 22 patients had CNS involvement. Here are our results. You can see that complete response was achieved in 92% of patients, and continuous complete remission is about 90% with median follow-up 35 months. Here is the overall survival curve. Of course, there were some treatment failures. We still have children with induction deaths due to toxicity or infections. And all those who had early relapse or didn't respond mostly were children with Burkitt lymphoma. So from this study, we concluded that immunochemotherapy allows achievement of long-term survival of about 90%, that we still have induction deaths, and we should do something with supportive care. Also understood that multicenter study is an important tool for diagnostic and improving the quality of treatment of children in Russia. And of course, in our future directions are to understand why some children are still resistant to chemotherapy and immunotherapy, and to understand how can we help them to be in remission. And one more point which we're going to do is to evaluate late effects of chemoimmunotherapy concerning immune reconstitution. I'd like to thank everybody, all participants of this study, especially our principal investigator, Yelena Samochatova, whose idea was to include rituximab in the treatment of B-cell lymphomas in children. And thanks for all doctors, nurses, physicians, patients, and their parents. Thank you.
Thanks. Thanks a lot, Natasha. Brilliant presentation, nice results. So, have anybody questions? Because I think it's so interesting experience. To my knowledge, this is the only protocol which incorporates rituximab as a first line treatment. And I remember from the beginning we had our doubts about how it can work, and now we are sure that it works, and we can reduce intensity of chemotherapy, which is extremely important for patients, especially with advanced disease from the beginning, when patient come with ascites, pleuritis, and huge tumor, and everybody knows how it's difficult to treat patients, especially induction of remission. So I think it's a big victory. So if anybody would like to ask something or add, thank you again.
Thank you.